This IRS document obtained by CNN is evidence of the largest anonymous dark money political donation ever reported, $1.6 billion. It is, according to experts, a staggering amount.
I am just stunned. We are talking about income that is many multiples larger than the largest dark money groups ever found.
And it's going to a new organization called Marble Freedom Trust. While you've probably never heard of it or the man in charge of it, the whole country is familiar with his work. His name is Leonard Leo, a devout Catholic known as Donald Trump's Supreme Court whisperer.
You know, every once in a while, journalists do such a good job that it spurs some pretty serious investigations. And in this particular case, Donald Trump's so-called court whisperer, Leonard Leo, is now facing an investigation by the DC Attorney General after Politico put out a report indicating that he might be enriching himself through his nonprofits. Now, how did he do that? I'm gonna lay out the case in just a moment, but understand that Leonard Leo had a tremendous amount of influence on the Trump administration, and more importantly, the Supreme Court. So this man's influence will impact this country and our lives for decades to come. He is the person who handpicked the three conservative Supreme Court justices that were confirmed during the Trump administration. He might not be as, I guess, attention grabbing as some of the other Trump cronies, but this guy, again, very well funded and has had a big impact on the country. So let's get into the details of what Politico was able to uncover through their investigation. So back in March of this year, Politico reported that one of Leo's so-called charities, called the 85 Fund, paid his for-profit company tens of millions of dollars in the 2 years since he joined the company. Okay, so let's get to that excerpt by Politico. The Leo aligned nonprofit, the 85 Fund, which is registered as a tax exempt charity, paid tens of millions of dollars to a public relations firm in Virginia, which Leo co-chairs, in the 2 years since he joined the firm, known as CRC Advisors. Okay, so this dark money gets funneled to the charity, the 85 Fund. And then the 85 Fund starts making these massive payments to the tune of tens of millions of dollars to for-profit companies that Leonard Leo is the head of. Now, an important thing to keep in mind is that Leonard Leo actually lived a very modest lifestyle up until 2016. Just keep that in mind as I continue laying out this case. So Politico reported that a total of $43 million flowed to Leo's company over 2 years, and that the bulk of it came from the 85 Fund, a nonprofit run by his allies, which has spent tens of millions of dollars over the past decade to promote Trump's Supreme Court picks, file briefs before the court, and more recently used an alias to push for voting restrictions and accuse Democrats of cheating in the 2020 election. Yeah. He's that guy. So beginning in 2016, his lifestyle changed quite a bit, okay? Over the two decades before he became Trump's so-called judge whisperer or court whisperer, Leo had maintained a largely middle-class lifestyle, okay? Directing one of Washington DC's many nonprofit organizations. He was associated with the Federalist Society, hence his handpicking of conservative Supreme Court justices. But since 2016, things changed. Politico writes that since 2016, however, his recent wealth accumulation has included two new mansions in Maine, four new cars, private school tuition for his children, hundreds of thousands of dollars in donations to Catholic causes, and a wine buyer and locker at Morton's Steakhouse, which I didn't even know was a thing, because I don't enrich myself through phony nonprofits and charities. But nonetheless, I will continue laying out this case. So what happened next? Well, Politico's reporting sparked an investigation from a watchdog group. And it turns out that the amount of money that was funneled from the 85 Fund to his for-profit companies for, you know, advisors and all that, much, much higher than Politico had previously found. So a Campaign for Accountability complaint alleges the total amount of money that flowed from Leo-aligned nonprofits to his for-profit firms was actually $73 million over 6 years, beginning in 2016. Listen, how are you gonna argue that this scheme didn't happen to enrich Leonard Leo when Leonard Leo's lifestyle very obviously changed from normal middle class dude to a guy who now has like multiple mansions, multiple cars, has a locker and a wine buyer at Morton's Steakhouse? Like, this is the thing about, like, he hasn't been convicted of anything, okay? So I'll say potential criminal. But this is the thing about potential criminals like Leonard Leo. They're stupid. Because if you are potentially breaking laws to enrich yourself, maybe don't be an idiot and buy multiple mansions and multiple cars immediately after you begin enriching yourself. I mean, it's unbelievable, but I'll continue. So the complaint by the Campaign for Accountability, which covers the period between 2016 and 2020, reads as follows. There are questions as to whether Leo-affiliated nonprofits have diverted substantial portions of their income and assets directly or indirectly to the personal benefit of Leonard Leo. Such payments were generally listed as made in exchange for alleged consulting. That's my personal favorite. Everyone's a consultant, right? Everyone. Consulting, research, public relations, or similar services. However, CFA, okay, that's the Campaign for Accountability, has reasonable questions about whether those alleged services are actually rendered at all, or if services were rendered, whether the payments made were substantially in excess of fair market value. I mean, I don't know. I actually have a good friend who is a consultant, like an actual consultant who helps to consult with media organizations and all that. He's not paid tens of millions of dollars for his consulting work. He's paid handsomely. Not tens of millions of dollars for it though. And the news of the investigation comes as that nonprofit, now that was the subject, this is my favorite part. As that nonprofit, which is the subject of this investigation, just quietly relocated from Virginia to Texas. Now, why would they do that? Could it be that Texas has incredibly weak laws regulating nonprofits? Could it be? I don't know, let me give you the details. In discontinuing the group in the state of Virginia, the new address listed is a virtual office suite in Fort Worth, Texas, shared by a two men and a truck franchise. The office building advertises virtual and co-working spaces. Now, things get even more shady. Get a load of this. POLITICO reports that in Texas, a new registration for the 85 fund was filed on June 27th under yet a different address in a different city than the one listed on the Virginia paperwork. It is also registered in Texas as a nonprofit entity. This location is a UPS store in a strip mall next door to a restaurant called the Snooty Pig Cafe. Snooty Pig indeed. Okay, now the 85 fund switch again from Virginia to that Fort Worth office building comes days after POLITICO inquired on June 30th about certain Leo allies who may have personally benefited from millions in anonymous donations that moved through the 85 fund over the past decade. So this is the dark money going to the nonprofit and then getting funneled to Leonard Leo and his friends, okay? Moving to Texas makes sense if laws pertaining to nonprofits have been broken. Texas has limited regulations when it comes to charities, making it a more attractive legal environment for nonprofits that are looking to potentially funnel money to private companies and enrich certain individuals. And again, this is not unprecedented. A good example of this happening is when the NRA, the National Rifle Association, moved to Texas after they were facing multiple lawsuits from attorneys general in New York and Washington DC. Now, a number of the groups that receive contributions from Leo's dark money network in turn hold sizable contracts with his firm, CRC Advisors. This includes the Federalist Society, the nation's preeminent conservative debating society where Leo was executive vice president and still serves as co-chairman. And among payments the complaint flagged to the IRS and DC Attorney General is $3.1 million, which the Federalist Society paid to CRC between 2020 and 2021 for media training. I mean, I'll train anyone in media training. If you're gonna pay me $3.1 million, I'll be the best trainer in the world. But here's the thing, media trainers, I don't even know if that's a thing, but if it is, they're not getting paid $3.1 million for their services. I can guarantee that. Now, this might explain, this whole situation might explain why Leonard Leo is such an advocate for dark money in politics. He loves it, he can't get enough of it. In fact, he doesn't do many interviews, but he did agree to sit down and speak to a conservative podcast called Main Wire. And during that conversation, he decided to talk about how, look, he's a lightning rod for criticism. You know, he doesn't really get it. You know, doesn't get why he gets criticism for being such a fierce advocate for dark money in politics. Leo spoke about the long history of dark money in US politics. Quote, "It's not to hide in the shadows," he said. "It's because we want ideas judged by their own moral and intellectual force." Right, right. I mean, he should tell that to the DC Attorney General investigating his potential, you know, self-enrichment through this charity. I'm sure it'll go over well. I'm sure that, you know, they'll buy this argument and this defense. We'll see. But the idea that dark money has been a mainstay in American politics since the beginning is ridiculous. And if dark money has done anything to this country, it has undermined our voice as ordinary Americans engaging in our democratic process. It has undermined our democracy. It has allowed for all sorts of shady behavior to take place and corrupt the halls of Congress with this disgusting money that again is obviously doled out for reasons that do not benefit ordinary Americans. So when you take a step back and you look at the policies that get enacted, when you look at the politicians who refuse to look out for the best interests of their own constituents, when you ask yourself, why is it that there seems to be a lot more agreement among Democratic lawmakers and Republican lawmakers when it comes to policies that enrich and benefit big business? Dark money's got a lot to do with it. Money in politics in general has a lot to do with it. And Leonard Leo loves it, he jumps in it. So we'll see how this case plays out, but I thought it was important to share it with you because dark money does more than just corrupt our politicians. Oftentimes it allows for shady figures to enrich themselves through so-called nonprofits.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.